हेलो गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस, दिस इज क्लास टेन, दिस इज क्लास टेन एंड द स्टूडेंट्स आर द क्यूरियोसिटी एंड द प्रॉब्लम दैट द इन द क्वेश्चन नंबर 8B. सो आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन नंबर 8B. यस, यू कैन सी इन द क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 प्रूव दैट द फंक्शन दिस एंड दिस आर इनवर्स टू ईच अदर. Prove that the function f x is equal to x minus 1 by 3 and g x is equal to 3 x plus 1 are inverse to each other. This means that if you find the inverse of one function, then the result is another function. So, for the proof of this part, you have to find the inverse of any function and get the result of other function. For the example, I am going to find the inverse of f function. Given that fx is equal to x minus 1 by 3, let y is equal to x minus 1 by 3. Now you have to write here, interchanging the position of x and y, we get instead y, you have to use x is equal to instead x, you have to use y. After cross multiplication, you get that y minus 1 is equal to 3x. And if 1 will be in that side, then 3x, it will be in the form of plus. So this is f inverse x, which is 3x plus 1. At lastly, when you see this is the function fx, this is the function f inverse. Now f inverse is 3x plus 1 and gx is also 3x plus 1. Therefore, f inverse x is equal to this function is what? Gx. Since fx and gx are inverse to each other, PROVD proved. By this way, you can prove this type of question. If you find the inverse of g, you obviously get the result f. That's why this process, you can prove the inverse of one function to another function. Now let's discuss in the question number 9b. Okay. So let's see the question number 9b. What is question number 9b? The 9b function are, okay, 9b function are gx is equal to x minus 2 by 3 and hx is equal to 3x plus 2. Prove that ghx is equal to, that is, identity function. So you have to understand about the identity function. Identity function is which type of function? The function which is in the form of y is equal to x is said to be the identity function. It means if the result get x, that is identity, as like that f x is equal to x, this is identity function. G h x is equal to x, this is identity function. F h g is equal to x, this is identity function. It means that find g h x and result must be x. X means identity. So let's find. For finding the g h composite function, at first you have to take here g x function. G x is x minus 2 by 3. And use h instead x, so here become h minus 2 by 3. Use ghx is equal to instead x, there is given value 3x plus 2, so use here 3x plus 2 and minus 2 remaining same by 3. So plus minus will eliminate, 3x by 3, this will be eliminate and result become how much? X. Therefore, ghx is what? X, which is identity function. Okay, by this process you can prove the identity function. Students, this is the very easy problems. If you have any confusion, then you can ask me on the messenger. And next question is for the question number 11. So let's discuss in the question number 11. What is in the question number 11? In the question number 11, the question is, if g such as n tends to n such that gx is equal to 2x and f such as n tends to real number such that fx is equal to 3x plus 4, then find g operation f. G operation f 4, here is as like g operation f 4 and f operation g, there is f operation g 3. Okay, f operation g 3. So let's discuss how can we find this type of question, how can we find the solution of this type of question. In reality, this is the question, g is a function, g such as n belongs to natural number. Here it do not do anything for us. This is the question for themselves. Gx is equal to 2x is the question and fx is equal to 3x plus 4 is the question. Now here is telling that n is the natural number and r is the real number. That will not affect us anything. So you have to find g operation f and 4. G operation f and 4. It means that this is g operation f 4 and another is f operation g and 3. So this is the question. Okay. So let's find this question. I am going to find only one type, that is g operation f. And the what is the question means that here gx is equal to 2x, gx is equal to 2x and fx is equal to 3x plus 4, that is 3x plus 4. Now g operation f 4 is equal to what? So for finding this, at first you have to find the g operation f at first, g operation f at first. So find as like gx is equal to 2x. Now use here f, then instead x you have to use f, that is 2 and the f is 3x plus 4. This is said to be g operation f, that is 6x plus 8. Now this is g operation f. Now you have to use here 4 instead x, there is needed the 4. So we are going to write g operation f, this is fx. Now g operation f, use there 4 instead x. So this become 6 times value of x is 4 plus 8. This is 24 plus 8. This is totally 32 is the required answer. Similarly, you can find the function f operation g3. Okay. Now let's discuss the question number 12. In the question number 12, what is the question? Let's see in the question number 12. What is the question? Gx is equal to 3x minus 2. Gx is equal to 3x minus 2. And g operation fx is equal to 6x minus 2 and f operation gx is equal to 8, then find the value of x, okay? Yes, this is VBI question. This is VBI question. This is the important question among that, okay? For that, here is given, here is given gx is equal to 3x minus 2. Is that clear? G operation f is equal to 6x minus 2. From here, at first, from the g operation f and from the gx, you have to find the function fx. After that, you have to find the function f operation gx. And after finding the f operation gx, you have to compare to each other, as like that. I have, at the previous class, I have told you, in this condition, you have to suppose or not. So, let's see here, gx function is given, first function is given here, so we don't need to let. But if the second function will be given, in this condition, we have to let, okay? But in this condition, we don't need to let here. Gx is equal to 3x minus 2. Now use here, because we have given gf, so in the form of x, use here f. So you also get, in the place of x, you also get f minus 2. So this becomes g operation f, x is equal to 3f minus 2. Now, we have already value of g operation f. What is the value? The value is 6x minus 2. The value is 6x minus 2 is equal to 3f. Is that right? Yes. After that, and minus 2 is remaining same. Minus 2 will be eliminated. And this, this become as like that. 3f is equal to 6 or 6x or 3 2 x, that is f is equal to 2x. F is equal to 2x. Now we find the function fx. So let's see. The question is f operation g is equal to 8. So at first find the function f operation g. Here fx is given. Just we find the value of fx, that is 2x. Just we find the value of fx as like the 2x. So use here 2x, but f operation g is 2 and instead xg. So this become f operation gx is equal to 2. The function of gx is given here 3x minus 2. 3x minus 2. This is totally 6x minus what? 4. This is totally 6x minus 4, but the value of f operation gx is, value of f operation gx is what? 8. So you can use here 8. Why are you using the 8? Because the question is find the value of x. That's why we are going to use here the value 8. That is 6x minus 4 is equal to 8. 6x is equal to 8 plus 4 is equal to 12, or x is equal to 12 by 6, that is 2. Therefore, the value of x is equal to 2, okay? The value of x is equal to 2. So, this is the important question for us. And this type of question are asking in the long question, 4 markable question. So guys, if you have confusion, then you can ask me. Thank you.